Dignities on the dais, my dear students, press, photographers, and all the other police officers, a very good afternoon to everybody. I'll not hold you long because it's lunch time and most of the points have already been spoken by the speakers. I'll just try to concentrate on some few points. I was just going through the notes of the police department where they have levied penalties on around 13 items and all those items, if we take care and if we ensure that they are followed, like wearing of the seat belt and helmets, and after that not doing drunken driving, not doing cell phone driving, etc., etc., then we'll be able to prevent accidents. Ipude Vishnu Garu has told just now, and it should be inspiring others also to follow that he and his brother could survive the accident because of wearing seat belts and wearing the helmets. So this is a really very good thing which was done by him, and it should be an example for others to wear seat belts and to wear helmets. Because we can learn from the people, celebrities like him, they will inspire you. Please follow this good quality of his. And that will definitely, a fraction of a second, if it is taken care of by wearing a seat belt or wearing a helmet, that will save your life. And that will lead to such, it will prevent the repercussions of affecting your family, affecting the society, that if you are safe, if you are alive, then, nothing happens. And if something happens, then you know, the entire family has to suffer. And in turn, the entire state has to suffer. Last year, there were 7,000 deaths in the state because of accidents. 7,000. It's not a small number. So we can prevent it by simple measures. And from the law side also, from the government side also, measures are being taken to adopt the policy of carrot and the stick. That means giving some rewards, educating as well as punishing. So you know that today, because of educating and because of levying penalties, drunken driving has come down to a great extent. Thanks to the police department, they have taken great care of that. Similarly, seat belt wearing and helmets also, that also is being ensured and it is being implemented by most of the drivers. So these small things will really prevent. Today it was told by one of the speakers that roads are very good in the state. Sometimes what happens when the road is good, we try to cross the speed limit. In that, we do accidents. So request is that please tell your parents, please tell your friends, please tell your teachers and others who may come in contact with that. The speed limit should be maintained on the road, and whatever the speed is prescribed, that has to be adhered to. Then only accidents can be prevented. Because unfortunately, we find many accidents are happening on the outer ring road, which is a good road. And people feel tempted to go and do over-speeding, and that leads to accident. Go slow, be graceful. Slow is grace. Take it that way. Speed is not thrill. Speed is not something which has to be emulated by the youth and all that. Going slow and steady should be taken as something which is graceful. Then only you will be leading a very, you will be avoiding accidents. Today we find that the youth has become really educated and they are following the norms which are being prescribed in society. And today we don't find anybody smoking. I am giving an example. We don't find anybody smoking on the road. They are very cautious. First of all, smoking has come down. Then they are not smoking in public places. Same is with drinking. So that can happen for the measures to be taken for avoiding accidents also. So we can request celebrities like Vishnu Garu to propagate this message of road safety. And in his films also, we request that if these messages could be given, it will go a long way in preventing accidents and keeping everybody healthy and without any, trauma in the family where the accidents occur. So it has to be a combined approach from the government side, from the family side, and you should act as a catalyst, the children, to motivate your parents, to peer group, your teachers, everybody, motivating them to ensure that they follow the rules. Similarly, the children also, unless until they get a license, prescribed license, a legal license, they should not drive the vehicles. Minors should not drive. Because only when you are eligible to drive, that time only you drive, and drive carefully, drive responsibly, otherwise it may lead to accidents. So a lot of responsibility lies on you also. Similarly, the parents who have come here also should educate the students to follow these prescribed norms, prescribed processes. So with this, as I said, all the points have already been spoken in the past. I don't want to take much of your time. I just wanted to tell you some important points. Let us go ahead. Let us go ahead as a unified force. Let us fight together against this evil of accidents by following the procedures, by following the rules. And simple things like, as I said, wearing the helmet, seat belts, non-cell driving, cell phone driving, and drunken driving should not be done. Then we can all ensure that driving the accidents can be reduced to the minimum, and there will be no, as I said, trauma in the family, in the society because of accidents. So I wish all of you all the best. You should do very well in life, and also spread this message of how to prevent accidents and what are the rules to be followed to prevent accidents, so that we will live in a better society and the accident-free society. Once again, all the best to all of you, and wish you all the best. Thank you.